nice, good, solid Bluebell. Nice bit of pathway. Nice moss. Nice shadow. It's all those things that are here somewhere, hopefully. That's good, it's only missing the white flowers. Quite like this bit here, looking through here. But the other thing is you've only got a small canvas. If you had a big canvas then you're looking differently. But when you've only got a small canvas, I've got this picture in my head that I can't see where, I can't find it, but it's here. I quite like this hole, but it's not obvious enough.
The badger.
See, that's quite a good sight. See, when you get the light, it lifts anyway. That tree trunk there is a good one. That'd be really good.
A bit of moss on it and things.
Focus is right on that yellow trunk at the very middle at the back there. So that'll be good.
Like the shadows on here, paint that. What colours have you got there then? What are you doing?
Always the same ones. I'll put out white, lemon yellow, cadmium orange, yellow ochre, burnt sienna, cerulean blue, French ultramarine, darker blue, Prussian blue, black, Van Dyke brown, and Windsor violet. Always the same. Can't get everything I need there with those colours. I'm straight in with the light. On that trunk. You can sort of see it, can't you? It's almost like just sort of colour in. That's what it is, isn't it? It's colour in. Sophisticated.
Colouring in, but you draw your own lines.
Kind of like half closing my eyes and it's kind of like,
yeah, you can start to see it emerging.
Yeah,
it's interesting how the light changes as well.
Well, that's the whole thing, isn't it, about working outside. So how do you cope with the changing light?
The shadows moving around things, I suppose, aren't there? And it's also the fact that it's going behind clouds and
shadows are moving. But you see, the word I never understood at art school was form, and the form doesn't change. The sort of places where the things are doesn't
the
change.
The shapes, yeah. Although the shapes in terms of colour do change, don't they?
Um, Yeah, I do, yeah, the shadows, for example.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a process of constantly refining, isn't it?
Yeah.
But when, how do you... Because art doesn't have to be photorealistic.
No. And it's changing all the time. This is what the kind of dilemma is for people.
So how personally do you decide where you're happy with that level of detail?
In this case, I can keep on trying to change in the wet paint the little bit I've done. But I know that if I block in some more, then it's going to develop. So I'm not necessarily going to just for the next 3 hours just keep trying to make that little tiny area work, because in order for that to work, it needs everything else around it. So I'm at quite an early stage of actually blocking in. If I can block this whole thing in, I mean, it's going to be surprising how much I'm probably doing. Seeing as that's about 15 minutes, in about 2 hours I'll have quite a lot in. And you've got to keep going at the same level. And then if I could get the whole thing in, it'll be an impression of it.
So the physicality of the actual technique means that you can only do so much detail at one time anyway.
So that's about the level of it at the moment.
So would you say you go as far as you can, given the medium?
Yeah.
If you just do a pencil outline of the basic shapes of the objects that are there.
Yeah. No colour.
And within those, there are colours, and the colours are shifting throughout the day, aren't they? And also, therefore, the shapes that the colours make within that framework changes. And I suppose that's what you've got there, in fact, on the page, is that pencil framework.
Yeah.
Initially.
Yeah, which is why I didn't need to do any more.
And then painting. You go into that with the colours, and that and they might shift within that framework.
Yeah, and I think Stanley Spencer used to draw very, very carefully, and then literally just fill in, like painting by numbers as you go. I'm kind of doing that a little bit as well. I mean, but physically exciting things to do are kind of putting in little tiny blobs of white paint to represent the flowers. You can do it, but you can't mess it too much because obviously it's going to mix in with what's there. It's surprising how much the beauty of oil painting is that you can paint over something. So you're gonna go so far with this. It could almost be easier if the sunlight does go in, because shadows are very seductive. You know, and you want to, but when they're not there, I mean, you can always lighten and darken something.
It's really good contrast, don't you?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I want to put the shadow there, but it's not going to make much sense. I think that's not a bad place to stop, because I need to let that, not let it totally dry, but it will be a bit dry. It won't be dry for another 4 days. But...
a bit colder, isn't it, as well? Beer time now.
Beer o'clock.
Oh, cut.
Try that one. It's a good shape tree over there. That one over there. That's got the top bit broken off.
These bluebells here are amazing.
That's a nice tree as well there with the white flowers in front of it. That tree trunk's a good one. This would be good to close up down here as well. We'd be close up on it. Isn't that lovely? That'd be really good. They like coming through the tree.
Yeah, good shape to those trees up there as well.
A bit of light at the top, that'd be lovely. Moving along a little bit. I like that. Like really nice kind of like flat shadows. What's that you get in your eye in after a day's painting? It's a bit the best bit comes, the best bit. At the end of the day when you finish, that's another one.
That's a really nice one there. Your eye starts to really
get in tune.
Yeah, you're sort of switched on.
Yeah.
That's a nice thing, isn't it? That's nice blue.
Nice soft green at the bottom.
Getting a bit darker now though.
Yeah.
Sun's starting to go down a bit.
Really colour, doesn't it?
Yeah, that green's unbelievable. That kind of colour that paint that and people would say that doesn't look real. It's like neon.
I've got a bit of it on there, I think. It's a bit too almost a bit vivid, isn't it?
Well, it is, isn't it? Well, nature is quite a bit vivid sometimes. Vlog.
It's a vlog.
Video vlog.
There it is.
The sky through the field, the road.